Would you like a professional, fun-filled photo shoot where beautiful memories are created? Then come to Photogenic Photography in River Horse Valley. Our calm and relaxed photographer will guide you through the whole experience with ease. Outfit changes, families, babies, portraits. We do it all. Call 076-912-2640 and book your shoot today. Photogenic Photography, creating an experience to last a lifetime.
The views and opinions expressed by our guests, listeners, and presenters do not necessarily reflect that of Southside FM.
Hi, this is Sid Sriram, and you are listening to Revathi Pillai on Youth Unplugged.
மின்சார பூவே பெண் பூவே மெய் தீண்ட வேண்டும் என்னோடு வாராய் என் ஆசையோசை கேளாய்.
Hi, this is singer Srinivas, and you're listening to Revathi Pillai on Youth Unplugged.
Okay, let's start the show with this catchy tune.
SA is indeed the future of this country. It is an absolute privilege for me to host a show to tackle the current challenges and opportunities that affect them. As a youngster, there are many decisions that pave the way for the future. This show is aimed at supporting the youth and encouraging them to make that decision. You can join me, Revathi Pillai, every Saturday between 9 to 12 as I bring four topics of interest. Remember, this is a show for the youth, by the youth.
Revathi's Vati Moment.
சப்பா பீட்டு குளித்துக்கடா ஆ மஜாப்பா மஜாப்பா டா 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 ஏ இடுடா வாடா பாத்தி கம்மி ஓகே
It's 7 minutes past 9 a.m. and a very good morning to you on this beautiful Saturday morning here. This is the Youth Unplugged Show. Revi Pillai is the name, here with you till 12 p.m. today. Boy, oh boy, did I miss that intro and did I miss my show. I have to say, as usual, I'm always having problems with my headphones, but I think I can still hear my voice. But it's been too long. It's been too long for me. I promise you, 3 weeks, I'm never doing that again. Manik also told me, where are you going? Don't go. But I definitely, I've learned my lesson. It was important. I'll let you guys know a little later on the show about that experience in Hyderabad and Delhi. It was absolutely awesome. I went as close as being able to meet Mahesh Babu's daughter. That's about it. I looked for him. All I could see was posters of him everywhere. But the experience and the course that I went to, it was absolutely amazing. But I'm going to let you know about that. Lots happening on the show, as usual. And that is at 9:15. We go straight into our motivation. This one's called Pencil Story. And thereafter, 9:25 and 9:30, around that time, we're going to do Are You a Kid at Heart? This is one of my favorite games. Because I was playing it, even in Hyderabad, I was like, guys, do you know what I do? And then I took it out and asked them the 5 questions. Eventually, the whole 30 of them were just screaming and answering. So I really enjoyed that. Thereafter, about 9:30, we're going to play that. About 10 o'clock, we will go into another game. And this one's called, it's kind of new. We did trial it before I could leave. It's called In the Classroom. And this is where I'm going to get my youth of the week, who's already eager and sitting next to me, to play. And then we're going to use our guinea pig across us. But we'll speak to him just now. And thereafter, a new segment. India has really opened my eyes. And with the stats that I'm looking at, this show is definitely all fun and games, and we do give the light and limelight to the youngsters. But there's another segment that I want to bring in, and that's just after 10:45, going into the last hour of the show, and we're going to call it Let's Get Real. And today's topic is very concerning to me, but we're going to chat about that a little later. It's something that actually happened in India, but it's no stranger to South African shores as well. But we're going to be chatting about that. You know, the show does not continue without the anthem, and that is Kutti Story.
What's up, Revati, on 074-345-447.
Let me sing a kutti story, pay attention, listen to me.
Nana, English?
Just listen, bro. Let me sing a kutti story, pay attention, listen to me. If you want, take guitars, when attention, leave it, baby. Life is very short, Nanba. Always be happy. Pallavida, problems will come and go.
Together, man.
Let me sing a kutti story. Pay attention, listen to me. If you want, take guitars, then attention, leave it, baby. Life is very short, Nanba. Always be happy. Design, designer, problems will come and go. Kunja chilpan maapi.
Attention, Pepe.
Speed up, Pona. Come on, must stay. Slow up, Pona. Steady, you must stay. Gonna hate but ignore calmly. Negativity around the live, baby. Focus on what you dream and don't worry, mabi. Positivity won't lift one, baby.
short, nanba. Always be happy. Very many problems will come and go. Kanja jilpanu maapi. Students, let me sing a good story. Pay attention, listen to me. If you want, take guitars, pay not attention, listen with me. Life is very short, nanba. Always be happy. Design, design now. Problems will come and go. Kunja jilpan maapi. No tension, baby.
Kuti story anthem here on Youth Unplugged. Welcome back to the show. This is Revathi Pillai, going to be keeping you company till 12 p.m. today, only on your favorite community radio station, Southside FM 107.2. Remember, ignite the South.
Design, design now. Problems will come and go. Kunja jilpan maapi. That was my kuti story. How was my kuti story? That was my kuti story. How was my kuti story?
Just awesome, na.
No tension, bebe.
Hi, Akhar Revathi. How are you doing? I hope you're doing well. And I missed you so much on radio. I never sent my messages for quite a while of time because you wasn't over there.
I can see.
And I'd just like to wish my friend that's Cameron Reddy a very, very happy birthday for today.
Happy birthday.
Hope he has a brilliant, awesome day. May God bless him with many more loving and awesome birthdays to come. And hope everybody has a good day out there. And you as well, Akhar Revathi, you have a good day as well. And I'd like to say hi to all my family and friends out there who's also going to have a brilliant day. And you take care, Akhar Revathi. Love you so much. I love you not. Love Nadia Pillai.
I love you lots like jelly tots too, Nadia. Thank you. I can see that. That's what surprised me because I'm looking at the message from Nadia and the last time she sent me was in Feb. And I was like, hey, Nadia, what did you do? But thank you so much. And I really missed you. Thank you for keeping me company as well on Facebook. I saw all the comments that you made. I noticed all of them. And thank you for being such a sport. So do take care. Revathi, it's so good to have you back. Missed you lots and lots. Have yourself a super awesome weekend. Stay safe. Lots of love. Take care. Rani in Chatsworth. And she sends me a good morning with a Tigger and a Pooh Bear. They're, both of them are my favorite, by the way. I'm definitely a kid at heart. I like Tigger and I like Pooh Bear. Eeyore, I can act like when I eat a whole lot, like a python. I can behave like an Eeyore. That's what happens. But remember to continue to send through your messages on 074-345-4447. It is now just after 15 minutes past 9 o'clock, and it is time for our motivational segment, and that is the story today is about a pencil and a pencil's life. Hope you enjoyed.
The Pencil's Tale. Once upon a time, an old pencil maker took his newest pencil aside just before he was about to pack him into a box. Imagining the little fellow as a person, he recalled a few things about the pencil. "There are 5 things you need to know," he said to his pencil. "Before I send you out into the world, always remember these 5 things. Never forget them. And you will become the best pencil you can be. The first thing is to remember that you will be able to do many great things, but only if you put yourself in someone else's hands. From time to time, you will experience a painful sharpening, but remember that this will make you a better pencil. Also, keep in mind that you will be able to correct any mistakes you might make along the way. And the most important part of you is what's on the inside. And remember this as well. Upon every surface that you are used, you must leave your mark. No matter what else happens, you must continue to write." It seemed the pencil listened to him and promised he would remember these 5 things so that he could live his life with heart and purpose. You see, in life, in your life, put yourself in someone else's hand. Embrace challenges for growth. Learn from mistakes. Value inner qualities. And leave a positive mark on the world. And you too can become the best pencil there is.
Vanakkam, I'm singer K.S. Chitra and you are listening to Revati Pillai on Southside FM. Stay blessed.
now 23 minutes past 9 o'clock. This is the Youth Unplugged Show. Revathi Pillai is the name. Going to be keeping you company until 12 p.m. today. Now, good morning, Dreshlin.
Good morning, Akka. Morning to the Southside FM Makkal as well.
Where's my traffic?
Your traffic? Well,
you know, I gave you homework, so I've been tasked. I'm actually quite honored that they take me as someone who's a real Vati, and they've asked me to train Dreshlin and get him up to speed, and that is why he's on the show. And now, as a youth, because he was one of my youth once upon a time, and now he's actually like a big man because his mustache is growing. But tell me, I gave you homework before I could go to India, isn't what I told you?
You told me to check the traffic update, and would that be
not even
said,
traffic? With traffic, because I said our Southside FM Makkal is still commuting during this time. It's morning, so it's good to add that element. And the fact that I've got you here now, I want you to learn time management, because every half an hour we'll give them that traffic. Where's the traffic, darling?
Well, it's 24 minutes past 9 that I learned.
Yes. What were you saying all this time? Oh, God.
No, so when I was co-hosting, I wasn't saying the time, because whoever was hosting used to say the time before I used to talk.
Okay, but so you learned that.
I learned it.
Okay, good. Yes. I left you in good hands. I hope Yogi Akawa was looking after you.
Yes,
I know
she was.
She would have.
Even Carlin. Carlin mentored me very well as
good.
Well.
Very good. Okay.
Our traffic update today in Durban. There's a stationary vehicle on the N3 eastbound at ramp to Ashburton. Right shoulder is closed. Notice of a road closure on the N3 both directions between Clutha and M7 Pinetown from Saturday the 23rd March 2024 from 5 p.m. until Monday the 25th of March till 4 a.m. The alternative routes for N3 towards Pietermaritzburg is the M10 exit and join M13 West, N2 northbound and join M19 West, the N2 southbound and join the M7 West.
Okay.
Stationary vehicle on the N3 westbound after ramp to pavilion is now clear. If you are in the vicinities, please do drive carefully. Stay safe out there. And remember, we know. If you have any traffic updates, please do let us know on 0743454447. That's your traffic update with Dreshlin Govinda.
Okay, I don't need so much from you, but I need to teach you how to do traffic. That is why I wanted you to actually, you know, continue to learn how to do it. But if you didn't do it, it's fine. We'll have offline courses. If you want to join, you can join. But we will speak. We're giving him a break, Kavesan, and we're going to be talking to him in a bit. But remember, friends and family of Kavesan, you can actually send through your messages to him on 0743454447. Vanakkam, Revathi. Trust you are well and enjoyed your holidays. Wasn't really a holiday. It was actually a 2-week course, but I'll let you know in a bit. We really did miss you. I missed you too. I missed all of my Makkal. But now that you are back, we are ready for your rocking show. Prashanthi is not feeling well, but both the girls send all of their love. Have an amazing day, Dvashni. Now, what's happened to Prashanthi? Oh, no. Obviously, I can't get a voice note from her, but all the very best to you, to both the girls. And Prashanthi, hope you get better soon, my dear. I know you're listening. I'm going to try to get your favorite song to come up next. I know, Chizit. You see, I know. This Vati knows what you like. I'm going to play directly when we're done with the rest of the messages. Vanakkam, beautiful Revathi Pillai. Tune into your great show. Good morning, Revathi. It's good to hear your sweet voice again. That comes from Rani and the previous one from Sivalingam Selvi. I like that name, Sivalingam. You don't always hear it. Yeah, true. Now, we're going to take some music, and when we come back, we will be playing Are You a Kid at Heart? This one is for you, Prashanthi. Hope you get better soon, my darling.
Chao.
from the movie Lakshmi Moraka Matraka. It is now 30 minutes past 9 o'clock. Welcome back to Youth Unplugged. Revathi Pillai is the name. Going to be keeping you company from now right up until 12 p.m. only on your favorite community radio station, Southside FM 107.2. Remember, you can stream us on Radio Garden or southsidefm.com. Alrighties, it is time to play Are You a Kid at Heart? But before that, my little one sent me a voice note.
Welcome, Revathi Akka.
Welcome.
It's so good to have you back on Youth Unplugged. And thank you for playing my favorite song. Love you lot.
I love you too, my darling.
Feel better now after hearing my Revathi Akka and my favorite song.
Oh, my dear. Thank you, my darling. As long as I could make you feel a little better, that is the aim here on Youth Unplugged. We're going to have lots and lots of fun, but I'm sure you're going to get better. Just lots of rest, listen to mum, and get mum to make some nice rasam for you. Rasam works, I promise you. Isn't rasam works, Kesavan? Okay, yes, rasam definitely works. So we've got a few seconds of an audio. I'm going to be playing it, and I just want to know what's the name of the it's a series. Also, they made a movie about it, and I promise you, I'm going to give you the biggest clue. I love these little blue guys. That's the biggest clue I can give you guys, but I love them. And if you know the name of the series or the movie they have made, and bonus, if you can tell me any of the characters, any name of any, you know, character, whether it's the female, any of the males, even the villain. The villain's name is quite funny, but I call some people that. But this is what it is. A few seconds of it. I can't give you too much because they say their name there. But if you know 0743454447, that's 0743454447, I'll give it to you one more time. I just want to know the name of the series that we also love and those little blue creatures. Well, if you know 0743454447, the first person to get it right will be playing Are You a Kid at Heart with me. Oh, I'm just loving this when I see WhatsApps coming through. Well, I think everybody loved this movie. And I'm sure everybody was actually smiling because all of you guys know it. That's what I love about it. Okay, 0743454447. I'm actually liking this new mashup. You would have heard it on the Big Breakfast Show as well. I'm going to play you one of them. Yeah, everybody likes that one. And apparently, now that I remember, on the 16th of June last year, I asked Kesavan to actually sing this, and he won tickets to the Sid Sriram concert during that time. We had a youth day events and all of that, and he won it during that time. And I asked him to sing it twice because he was so good at it. So let's see if we can actually pull that off again this time. All right, so we're going to talk to him in a bit, and he tells me when he's ready. But we've got a few right answers here. Now, we're going to be calling the first person who actually got it right. So let's see if we can get a hold of them. Rishan, are we good? I like having someone to help me now. It's so nice. Otherwise, I have to do everything myself. A very good morning to you, Drishanta. How are you doing?
Let's see.
It's still
ringing.
Quality is important on the show.
Hello.
A very good morning to you, Drishanta. How are you doing?
Hi.
How are you? I am well, thank you. Do you know who's speaking?
It sounds like Revithyaka.
It's most definitely. I am promoting nepotism today. So we got your brother on the show this morning, and we said, no, you were definitely, I did not crook it. You were the first person to get it right. What's the name of that series, my dear?
Thank you.
What's the name?
I'm so sorry, I can't hear you.
So I'm saying, what's the name of the series?
Maths.
Ah, definitely. It's the Smurfs.
It's my favorite.
It's your favorite. Okay, no, definitely it's your favorite. So, tell me, are you ready? It's five questions, Disney-related and, well, Nickelodeon as well, a bit of everything. Are you ready? It's five simple questions, and if you get all of them right, you're definitely a kid at heart.
Okay, I am ready.
Okay, all right. And I'm going to be very kind because the way I am promoting nepotism right now, if you don't get it right, we will get your brother to answer it. How's that? One youth to the other. Are you willing to help her?
I don't think I'm going to have to help her. I have faith in her.
Okay, all right. He has faith in you, so please.
Don't let me down.
Yeah, we will not let you down. Don't worry. Okay, first question. Which company in a Disney movie has the slogan, "We scare because we care"? Which company in a Disney movie? So there's a Disney movie, and it's also the name of the movie. It's a company, and they've got a slogan, "We scare because we care."
We scare because we care.
The way that smile left his face, but
we
anyway.
We scare because we care.
I actually liked him, as I was like Mike Sullivan and all of these.
Monsters.
I'm so proud of her. Say it, carry on.
Ink.
Okay, all right, next one. What does the phrase Hakuna Matata from The Lion King mean?
Be happy.
Okay, all right, we will give you that one. Which Disney film features the song Let It Go?
Frozen.
Oh, look at that little girl. Typical. Which Disney film features the question, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?"
You say this all the time to yourself.
She's so conceited.
Can I give her the hint?
No, we'll come back to that one. Who plays the princess in The Princess Diaries? I absolutely love this actress. I'll give
in
you
the
clues
princess
as well.
Diaries?
Yeah, The Princess Diaries, I watched all of them. Who's the actress that plays the princess, Princess Mia, in The Princess Diaries? And if you're a princess fan, you cannot tell me you did not watch this movie.
Anne Hathaway?
Yep. Okay, all right. So one more time, the fourth one. Which Disney film features the question, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?"
So you want the name of the movie?
Yes.
Snow White!
Oh, you're such a drama queen, but I'm loving you. All right, you got 5 out of 5, and congratulations. You're definitely a kid at heart. While I've got you on what would you like to say to maybe your brother, or a shout out to whoever's listening?
Hello to my Southside family. It's good to be on radio again. And we missed you so much, Revati Akka. I missed you on your show. And hi to my brother as well.
I'm just glad you didn't let me down.
I want to know, we brought him here to learn. Why you didn't come with?
Unfortunately, I have to study. I have writing exams.
Okay, and then we'll give you this year because you're in an important grade. How's next year?
And it cut.
Oh, dear. Okay, but thank you, Drushantha, for that. And she's definitely a kid at heart. I'm very proud of her.
I'm glad she didn't let me down.
No, she wouldn't have let you down. Don't stress. The right answers as well from Vasagi Chinsami. She says it's the Smurfs. We got a voice note here from Aiden.
Hi, Vati. It's the Smurfs.
Oh, my dear. It's the Smurfs for sure, Aiden. I'm very proud of you. Smurfs, my fave. It's cute little Smurfette. I also like Smurfette as well. Gargamel, Smurfs. Deshni, I agree. Gargamel was another story, but that was Gargamel. There was a little toad thing that was with him. I forget what's the name of that one. Was it Dookie or something? Smurf says Dvashni as well. Let's see here. Smurfs, a grumpy Smurf. Yes, a lot of people say I can be grumpy Smurf. No name here. So if you are sending through messages, make sure you do send through your name, because I know I get a lot of first time WhatsApp is here. So please do send your name through. Messages already coming through as well. So a very good morning. Vanakkam, a beautiful Revati, and a handsome youngster sitting next to you in the panel. That is my youth of the week, Kesavan Govinda. We're going to be chatting to him in a bit. He is absorbing everything that we do here, but he was nervous, but I can see that. He's still nervous. And Snow White is who is trying to help. And that comes from Andy Mudley. Thank you so much for helping, Drushantha, on that, Andy. Let's see here. All the best on your musical journey, Kesavan. May Sri Krishna guide and protect you always. Love from your family in King Williamstown. Okay, so Kesavan, who's that?
I think that's my auntie.
That's your aunt? You think it's your auntie?
No, actually my granny. Yeah. That's my father's auntie.
Oh, okay, all right. So the whole family is coming through. Okay, so remember, you can send through your messages on 074-345-4447. That's 074-345-4447. Kesavan's definitely awaiting it. Another remix here, and also one of my favorites. Yenge and the Vanilla, and that's a remix. I actually really, really like that song, especially the original of it. Onimen, you cannot beat him. I think that from Yesudas to his son, and then to Onimen, and to the others as well, they all have that distinct voice, and it's a Kerala voice. I think it's the water in Kerala that makes them sound like that. But I need to go to Kerala to drink that water if that's how they sound, definitely. So a very good morning officially to you, Kesavan. Govinda, how are you doing?
I'm good, thanks.
Okay.
How are you?
Good. Now, I deliberately made you chill in, saw what I was doing,
yeah,
with Dresh and all of that. So you're comfortable now?
Yeah.
Not that nervous?
I am. A little bit.
I can't understand. You already a singer. You perform in, you know, in Nelungus, you were telling me. You did it on stage that day. We even asked you to sing again. You're a celebrity in Tongat. How can you be nervous?
It's the first time I'm here on radio, so.
Ah, no, don't worry. Yeah. If I can do it, anyone can do it.
Okay.
Don't stress. There's some messages coming through. Let me see. A voice note first. And this one comes from, let's see what he has to say.
Hi, this is Swami Reddy, and you're listening to Southside FM. Keep listening. Yes, wishing Priya Kistane a very happy birthday for today. Have a great one, Priya. All the same birthday. A very happy birthday goes out to your best wishes from Swami Reddy Ulara. Scooby Dooby Doo. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Swami Reddy. And I think that's a very nice voice of yours. I don't know about you guys, but the way he did it and he started it, I liked it. I really did. Vanakkam, wishing my baby brother all the best for his first radio interview. He has surely made me a very proud big sister and came a long way in the music field. May he be blessed in abundance and continue with amazing journey he is following in this music, especially with calling praises to our great Lord, sending him lots of love from his only sister, Krinel. So while we take this opportunity, because I want to say it's Krinel is the reason as to why you are sitting here. Krinel called me. I remember I was in the consulate's office and I was getting ready and she was like, this is it. I heard what you did with Aiden, and Aiden is actually getting quite a lot of offers, and people have now recognized his Casio skills and the way he plays it. And if you can, you know, have my brother on, I think no problem. I mean, this show is for the youth, by the youth, as I always say. And we made that arrangement, but she's been following up. Even when I was in India, she followed up and I asked her for the demo and all of that, just to get an understanding of, you know, what I'm going to be dealing with. But a big shout out to Krinel, and I think you are an amazing big sister, because you took the initiative to showcase your younger baby brother, as you called it. But while we're talking about Krinel, take this opportunity. I know you both must fight at some point. Sister brother, typical cat and mouse, Tom and Jerry at home for some reason. But as another mum that she is, that she's displayed to me for the past few weeks, what would you like to say to Krinel?
I would like to take this opportunity to thank whatever she done for me in my musical journey, and she's been a true inspiration, and she's been there whenever I need her by giving chorus and stuff for satsang and stuff. So I would like to take this opportunity to give her a shout out for the amazing sister that she is.
She most definitely is an amazing sister. So thank you once again, Krinel. It means a lot. I've got another voice note here. Let's see what it says.
Vanakkam, Vati.
Oh, Vanakkam.
We missed you.
I missed you.
Guess who it is?
Aiden.
It's me, Aiden. I would just like to tell my Anna that we are so proud of him. And he must continue to fly the Govinda flag high. Well done, Anna.
Oh, I just love this child. He's bow tie and he was my Valentine. He was absolutely adorable. Aiden, it's his voice. There's just something about his voice. When he first sent me the voice note before I could interview him, I was like, no, bring him. I want to talk to him. The voice just actually fell in love with his voice more than I liked Sid Sriram's voice. It was absolutely amazing. But thank you so much, Aiden, for that message. Obviously, he looks up to you as a role model. And yeah, that's a lot on your shoulders. Now, all the best. Okay, now I have to read it, but usually I don't use slang. All the best, Lighty, from Swasi Sai and Suri. Who is this?
This is my uncle,
Saravan. Uncle who?
Uncle Saravan.
Uncle Saurav, you're making me say slang words. What is wrong? Good morning. Love this track. I agree. Even Selvi Sivalingam says beautiful voice of the legend Uni Menon. It was an absolute honor to have met him as well. He's so humble, but when he doesn't need the graphics, he doesn't need any of that. When he sings, it's just from the heart. And you have the same. You definitely have the same. Good morning. This is Kian Brahmadu. Sending support and love to my friend, brother, giving him my blessings. Om Namah Shivaya. Okay, so that's your friend.
Yeah, from my charming group too.
Ah, okay. Namaskaram, Vanakkam, Revi. Hope you had a nice break. Glad you are back. Good to hear my Goldie and my princess voice on Southside FM. Thank you. I feel I'm blushing now.
That's grand.
My princess voice is on Southside FM. Grand, miss you all so much. All the best, Kesavan. You make us all proud. Keep shining. Rishan, you are a fast learner with Revi. Yes, he better learn. Next time he does traffic next week. Yeah, we're going to teach him. Don't worry. You'll rock. Tons of love from Gran in Port Chepstow. So continue to send through your messages. I'm going to stop there. There is quite a lot. Remember, send them through on 074-345-4447. Now tell me, Kesavan, one of the most important things before we can go into school, we can go into everything. You're coming from Tongaat.
Yes.
Okay. How is Tongaat? The last time I was in Tongaat, we did the live with Aquile and the truck. And I know we had quite a lot of water issues, as usual in Tongaat. I have been before I could go away, but how is it right now with the water and the issues?
The state at the moment is very bad. There's been burn packets lying everywhere on the corners of the roads due to DSW going on strike and whatever.
Okay, so that's just an add-on now with the dirt everywhere.
Yeah, more pollution and stuff. That's something that I don't like at all. And water problems, there's no lights and stuff. Children are coming to school with colored clothes.
You don't blame them because they can't wash their clothes.
Yeah.
And with the power cuts, some of them can't even iron their clothes.
Yeah, that's true. So that's the problem so far.
So the water is still an issue. Mum was telling me that it actually went off this today.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure when it's going to come on. But as a youngster, and I'm sure, you know, you'll talk about it in school and stuff. And the reason why I ask is because it obviously is affecting you all, and it needs to be brought to someone's attention, whether it's the counselor, the mayor, for example. Children need to concentrate, especially your grade 12s, in order that you'll need to concentrate every day at school is a priceless moment.
Yeah.
And you're having a challenge to even get there. But in school, do you get like drinking water and all of that, or just for the ablutions? Nothing.
I would really feel bad to say, but the school that I'm in, they have bottles and stuff, but they don't really give us drinking water. So we have to take our own drinking water to school.
But it's also safer to take your own as well.
Yeah.
Because right now with the water cuts, you don't know if it's actually clean coming back immediately or you have to boil them.
Yeah, but I'm on my point of view, on a hot, sunny day, the children just feel dehydrated quickly. Yeah,
and there's only so much. And it's not like you're carrying a 5 liter with you.
You cannot.
You're only taking a bottle and a small one, a 500 ml or a 750.
Yeah.
It's not going to last you that whole 5 hours or so that you're in school.
And the school doesn't really provide water, so it's a big problem.
I've been now to 3 schools, high schools there, and unfortunately, they're feeling the pinch, the issue with the water.
Yeah.
So the schools, at the end of the day, the school is there to provide education, but they're also trying their best, I know, to provide the water. But besides that, taking water, how is it also affecting you mentally and the way to perform in school? Is it affecting you guys?
A bit. Because if you don't get to school on time, it becomes a problem.
Mm-hmm.
So can't really wash clothes, can't really wash our school clothes and, iron them and stuff. So it's really becoming a big problem.
It is. Yeah. I'm sure it is. So, yeah, I know there's no concrete solution to this. But I must say hats off to every single Tongaat listener that's tuned in right now. you guys are heroes. You guys are strong.
Yeah.
What is happening to your area has been happening now for a long time, a very long time.
Yeah.
So definitely I hope, I pray that it gets sorted out. But remember, if you'll stand united, which you all are doing, I can see that, all the voices put together, I'm sure a change will come through.
Yeah.
I'm hoping. Definitely. I'm hoping it will come through, especially in May. Let's see now. Monica, wishing my baby brother all the best for his radio interview. He's made me very proud, and please pass this message on to my brother. We'll truly appreciate it. So let me see here. I'm so sure I saw another one here, but let me just get to it. Okay, Vanikam, we are super proud of you, Kesavan and Krini. They are such an inspiration to the youth. May Amma continue to bless them in abundance. Om Shakti Parashakti. And this one comes from Cindy N.
Okay.
All right, who's Cindy? They don't explain how they are related to your 45th cousin. That's why I ask these questions.
Yeah, one of my old family friends from Balito.
Ah, okay, all right. May you always be blessed in abundance and keep doing what you do. You have come far and I wish you all the best in the journey. I'm proud to say that I have met a singer like you. Continue making Mom, Dad, Cranny and the rest of us proud. Lots of love, Brother Vish. So who's Vish?
One of my friends.
One of your friends.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, there's another youth, but he's very shy in the studio.
True.
And he doesn't want to come and say hi. Maybe we'll get him to say hi. You know, that's an accomplishment from both of our sons.
Yeah.
What's his name?
His name is Yeshlin.
Now, Yeshlin came through, and why doesn't Yeshlin want to talk? Is he always so shy?
He's always.
Oh, okay, okay. Always. I just thought the show, and I was making him feel shy.
No.
Okay, all right. He's a shy boy.
Yeah.
And you're the extrovert.
A little bit. Both sides.
All right, it is 10 o'clock now on the Youth Unplugged show. It is time to play another game. And this time, I don't know if he was taking out his encyclopedia and all his notes, Rishlan, on the other side, seeing what does do they
I'm
have.
Worried.
Yes, I can
I'm
see.
Worried.
Okay.
Because when you were telling us about the topics, now I'm thinking, I don't even remember.
Okay, we will remember. The Makkal is here. Why I can confidently play any game? Because you saw when Dhruv was having a problem, someone came through and answered it. That's the best part of my Makkal. They will come through and they will help you. So, this part of the game is called In the Classroom. Okay, so we're taking you back. A bit of nostalgia for Duresh as well. But it is In the Classroom. I'm giving you guys two subjects. Okay?
Okay.
Now, the first one is biology, and the second one is geography. And because you're my youth of the week and my cello, you get to choose. You want geography or you want biology?
Geography.
Geography. Mister?
Let me just say on air right now, I didn't do bio, I didn't do physics, I didn't do geography. My
you
sister
went past
is
the
one.
No.
I
you went
past
the
school.
from what I'm listening.
I did business. If you want to talk business, I can talk business.
No. Boring that is. Business is boring.
But let's see what I can do with bio.
So we're going to ask you, right? Geography. So geography is 5 questions. I like to keep it to 5 questions. And if you get it all right, you definitely a very smart boy, but even if you do, you are already a smart boy. And then we can check with Rish. If he can get all 5 right, he's going to be doing bio. You want to go first? You're happy?
A bit.
A bit. Okay, all right. Let's go. Remember, when I look for these questions, irrespective of how old the person is, I go to grade 3, geography, grade 5, biology, and I try to get all of these.
Okay.
So I keep it as simple as possible. Right, here goes. Name any 3 of the 5 oceans.
Pacific Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Atlantic Ocean.
Which hemisphere does Australia lie on?
Western Hemisphere.
Which hemisphere does Australia lie on? You can ask for help by looking at someone who's trying to tell you the answer.
Southern Hemisphere.
He's so cute. He's holding his phone, flinging his brother. He's like, it's southern. What is the capital of Spain?
Yo.
You play soccer?
No.
Soccer?
I don't play soccer.
Oh, can't help you. Okay, what is the capital of Spain? Okay, we'll come back. Marco, we need help. Please help my youth of the week, Kesavan. What is the capital of Spain? Number 4. What are the horizontal and vertical imaginary lines around the Earth called?
The equator.
No.
What are the horizontal and vertical imaginary lines around the Earth called?
Atmosphere.
We'll have to come back to that one. Which South American country has land borders with 10 other countries? It's the name of a nut as well.
I'm not too familiar with that.
You're not too familiar with that?
No.
Okay, that's fine. You got 2 out of 5. Let's see, the others are coming back with some answers. Biology! You ready, Dreshlin?
No, you got 2 out of 5. I'm going to be lucky if I get 2 out of 5, yeah?
I'm telling you guys, it's all easy. And if you are comfortable, you can ask help him as well. Because mm-hmm. I saw he didn't help you, but it's fine, you can help. It's okay. What? Now, you ready?
Yeah, yeah, I'm ready.
What is the largest organ in the human body?
I think it's the heart. Yeah, I think it's the heart. I'm going to go with the heart.
Okay. Which organ in the human body is responsible for pumping blood?
The heart.
What is the process called when plants release oxygen into the air?
Photosynthesis.
Which type of animal lays eggs, mammals or reptiles?
Reptiles.
And true or false, the human brain weighs more than the human heart?
True.
Okay. All right. How so you
wait,
think you've...
So wait, now.
No, you finished Lockett, I'm sorry.
Yeah, yeah, no.
What's the answer?
No. I think I got 4.
I feel I should have just picked biology.
No, you actually
I think I got the first
well.
One wrong, though. I think I got the first one wrong.
Okay, but you're happy with whatever you answered.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just run with it.
All right. No, I think you did very well. You got 3 out of 5.
Oh, okay.
See, you must have
a little bit faith.
Confidence and faith in you. No, but you did very well as well. Now, what you did get wrong is the largest organ in the human body is actually the skin.
The skin.
And it's false. The human heart weighs more than the brain.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why they say
the heart's heavier than
the heart is heavy. You're making my heart feel heavy. Yes, definitely. So that is it. It's obviously going to be fun when we try to get the phone line sorted out here. But more messages coming through. Vanakkam Revathi, trust you well. Welcome back. All the best to this lad in the future endeavors. Also, I think I may have seen you at Total this morning. I think you did because I did stop to get Dylan. But you didn't come and say hi, Dylan. How is this now? My fault. But anyway, next time you see me, wave, say hi, scream my name. I'm so used to that as well. And just come and say hi. Not a problem. I did go to a Total today. So if you did see me, I went to get a nice hot chocolate because I needed to start my day. Chocolate helps me, but it's very bad for you. You mustn't have it. Namaskaram. I feel proud of this young lad from Tongat. Really makes us proud of our town in the north coast. And that one comes from Vish. Dina sends a voice note. Let's see.
Keshlin, the answer is Madrid.
Yes, it's Madrid is the capital. I was giving you the wrong answer. I saw. Good morning, Akka. Hope you're well. We would like to congratulate Kesavan on his radio debut. Oh, so it's a first time?
Yes.
Okay, all right. I'm actually honored that it's on the show. May this be the first step of endless opportunities. We are proud of you, Lavani and Viro. We are his dad's cousin sisters. Now, I am so proud of them. They are explaining the 45th cousin thing to me. Thank you so much for that. Now I understand Vani and Viro are your dad's cousin sisters. Yes. Thank you. Enjoy your day, Akka. Stay blessed and keep up the excellent work. Soon, my whole family will be on radio with you. Actually, I've got the whole family. Now, tell me from left to right, who's joining us? Because he's not alone, by the way, Michael. He's not alone. He's come with the entire family. And this is the, I think, what I love about it is when a youth comes and the grandpa wants to come, or the grandma, or the mum, or the dad, and the siblings, it just shows how much they actually support the youngsters. So tell me the names, please.
Okay, so that's my granddad.
Uh-huh.
That's my mom's dad.
Uh-huh.
And that's my mom.
Mm-hmm.
My friend from
Benjamin
Hoops. Okay, sorry.
I know the relation. I just need the names.
Okay. My granddad's name is Perumal Murugan.
Uh-huh. Mr. Perumal Murugan.
My mother's name is Julie Govinda.
Uh-huh.
And this is Yashlin Govinda.
The shy one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And my dad's name is Kandasamy Govinda.
Oh, I like the name Kandasamy.
Kandasamy Govinda. Okay, so the whole family is here to support you, Kesavan. You're very proud while we have this opportunity, and you've got all of them in front of you. What would you like to say to them?
Thank you all for just allowing me to carry on with my spiritual journey. And yeah, I hope I go far away with it.
No, you definitely will go far in life with it. We're going to take some music, and when we come back, we're going to continue chatting to you about school, and then we're going to get you to sing for us.
முந்தினம் பார்த்தேனே பார்த்ததும் தோற்றேனே சல்லடை கண்ணாக நெஞ்சமும் புண்ணானது இத்தனை நாளாக உன்னை நான் பாராமல் எங்குதான் போனேனோ நாட்களும் வீணானது.
ஹலோ எவ்ரிவான், திஸ் இஸ் நரேஷ் ஐயர் அண்ட் யூ ஆர் லிஸ்னிங் டு சவுத் சைட் எஃப்எம் வித் ரேவதி பிள்ளை. Thank you.
Make me sweat.
that was Tyler Water, and I must say that youngster, it would be an honor to have her on the show. For sure, she is creating waves, and we're very proud of her. Hi Revdi, this message is for my brother. How can you let me down on biology? We studied this together on for my exam, and we spoke about the skin being the largest organ the other day.
No.
So I let me answer that. You know, I don't know, Drew. We tried with him, but biology, I don't know where he went wrong, but I must say 3 out of 5 is good.
She should be proud. At least I passed.
Yeah, but we
it's a pass.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
scraped pass. You know, she was expecting a 90
hoping,
from you.
I was hoping for like 2. I got 3.
Divashni says, capital of Spain is Madrid. Definitely. I see all of them. The capital of Spain is Madrid from Cindy Naidu. There's all the soccer fans you can see. Vanikam, good morning. Wishing Kesavan all the best. So proud of you. Love from Divesh and family, neighbor and friend. You see, I like how all of them are complying. They're explaining who they are. Hi, Revdi. This message is... okay, I've got... I read that one there that came through twice. Yeah, so continue to send through your messages on 074-345-4447. Also, Vanikam Revdi, we are super proud of our kids. Amma's blessings upon them. That comes from Cindy Naika. Savi Mudli says, Vanikam Revdi, lovely youth program as always. And good morning, Revdi, comes from Veena Naidu. You have the most beautiful voice for radio. Thank you. Appreciate it. And I adore your personality. I try. I even get fed up with my personality sometimes. Thank you for being such an inspiration to the youth. To my baby Dresh, you are learning from the best. And soon, I'm not going to even be quite about that. I'm going to read it. And soon, you're going to just be outstanding like that. I know you. Proud of you. Keep going. Love you guys. Veena from Johannesburg. If he listens, he can learn a lot. I will learn. This Vati is very... When I'm with my youth of the week, I'm, you know, it's the child we talk, but when you are my full-time student, I'm one of the strict teachers. Very strict. Because I started on the 13th of May, I had 2 strict people, but hey, it worked.
I won't walk past the school this time.
Don't walk past the school. Hi, beautiful Revdi. Great show. Not for the youth only. I enjoy it. Greetings to handsome Dresh. Continue making us proud. You're a natural. You're going to do good. And love you lots from Mala Grams. That's granny, I'm assuming.
Grandsister, yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right. Continue to send through those messages. 074-345-4447. So how's school going?
It's going well.
It's going so well. Far. You sound like, why am I in school?
grade are you in?
I'm in grade 11.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
It's going to be grade 11 now. So
big year.
Big year. Very big year. So tell me, when, which one is? Okay, I'm assuming that one is. It should be fine. Be very quiet. Come closer to the mic.
Okay.
All right. You didn't have breakfast.
I did.
I didn't have breakfast. Just had the chocolate, hot chocolate. That was about it. Okay. But that should give me enough energy till 1 p.m. till I go see what my mom made. Okay. Now tell me, you know, with school and all that, what subjects? Grade 11, what's yours?
Yeah, I'm doing consumers, geography and tourism.
Okay.
And
I like that.
The rest
is
compulsory subjects, life orientation, maths lit, and English.
Okay. Mm. And which is your favorite?
And Afrikaans. Consumer studies because of cooking. I actually want to become a chef.
Awesome.
Yeah.
When you become a chef, you need to cook for me.
Definitely I will.
Okay, all right. I don't like to cook. The only thing I can make is poli. That's okay. About it.
I love poli.
I'll make for you. One day when I'm coming to Tongat, I'll make for you and I'll tell you, okay, share the address, live location, and I'll come in.
Okay.
So I usually do see you if I do visit Tongat in a temple or something.
Yeah.
So I definitely will come and visit you. But yeah, no, I think I need to take classes from you. I don't get the time to cook. That's my problem.
Yeah.
But I will start learning. So cooking is something is that first preference, first choice is to become a chef?
Yeah.
Okay, and what's the second? Option B. I always say a chef must always have an option B.
That's really hard to think about.
It's okay, I'll give you some advice. If you are going to look at plan B, which I always advise everyone to have, just in case, I know the chef route is going to work for you because your passion is there.
Yeah.
To choose a plan B, you always look at what else is your strength. You know, you're studying tourism, hospitality.
Yeah.
You want to become a chef. So why don't you study something where if chef doesn't work, or you can have a backup where if you go into the hospitality, you have options of actually going into many avenues.
Yeah.
So that's an option as well, because I like the fact that you're touching on tourism, because that will then take you. So that's an option. That's.
I think just for now, I have my mindset just on culinary, and maybe with the my musical journey and stuff, I plan on going and continuing my classes, maybe India or maybe abroad.
You watched Annapurani?
I love the movie. I love that movie.
I loved watching it. Yeah. It's on Netflix. Mm. And I know there was some controversy thereafter where they had to take it out. I think they took it off.
Oh, no.
But there were some issues. But when I watched it, I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Yeah.
It just shows the love for, you know, cooking and going your path. But is it just general cooking? Or like, is there a specific... you want to go into pastry and all of that?
Mostly street food.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, that's... the vibe to go, because you can even take that anywhere and you can actually cook.
And then I plan on growing myself maybe to becoming a master chef.
I'm gonna see you on TV one day.
Hopefully.
No, I'm sure you will do well. Was it Dina that won the last one I watched in South Africa?
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna be another one for that matter. Okay, so with school, everything is well? All good?
Everything's good. I can't say much about school.
Yeah, I can see that. You seem to be one of those kids.
I'm done with exams now, so getting into term two.
So many of them are telling me they're still busy with the exams, with all the kids that I've been chatting to.
Yeah.
How you think you did?
Well, just geography. I'm just worried about geography, but not too worried. You made me worried on the spot now.
I know. This is... What I asked you is, seriously, I took from grade 4, grade 3.
It's just that soccer is not my thing, otherwise I should have got that.
Yes, you have got that, but don't worry, I'll tell you that you passed. I'm the Vati, I can say it. You passed.
Yeah.
Don't worry. Now, with music, everybody, third generation of music, how did that all happen? And why did it come to you? I mean, your siblings and stuff are also maybe in it. But it seriously comes quite naturally to you.
Mm-hmm.
When did that love or that understanding of music actually start?
So it actually started when I was 6 years old.
Mm-hmm.
I went for an open prayer at Gyaneshwar Temple, and I met Veeramani Kannan.
Uh-huh.
And so he was going on singing Ayyappa songs and stuff. And I was like, okay, this is a different vibe. So I went home
that type of song.
Yeah. So I went home that same afternoon and I realized, no, all the songs are in my head. I'm like, what?
It stuck.
Yeah, so I've been irritating my mom and dad and my sister for a couple of weeks and weeks and weeks. And then until today, my dad reminds me, no, there was an Ivan song that you learned from Veeramani Kannan that day. And I was like, no, I can't remember. Yeah, so I really thought my sister would have been sitting here today instead of me, because she's a bigger one. She went for a wedding, one of her friend's weddings. Yeah.
Oh dear. No, but you know, like she said in the message, she's more than welcome to come through. She is absolute sweetheart from day one with communicating with me.
Yeah.
But so it started there, but it's not only singing that you like.
No.
You play the tabla.
Now and then, and then I also have a drumming group of youth.
Your own drumming group?
Yeah.
Okay, I like that. Yeah. Leadership skills. Yeah. When that started?
About 6 years ago.
No.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, so it's all youngsters. It's a youth group for in Tongat.
Yeah, and the passion for drumming started off with my granddad, actually. Mm. You should tell me the stories about the tiger dancers and stuff in Glado and stuff. So... Mm. Drumming, tiger drumming actually came up to me from him, and all the motivation I got from playing the side drum to the main lead tasa, it's called a tasa actually.
Mm-hmm.
So the group is growing, and I'm planning on bringing you together, having fun, getting some power, some strength actually. It's like multitasking thing, you can do too many things at the same time. So planning on keeping them away from the bad habits and stuff, so. Yeah.
Okay, all right, interesting. I like what you're doing. I really am taken back. It's the first time I'm hearing about it.
Yeah.
And the fact that how many youth, by the way, is in your class? On your group?
There's about 13 boys, yeah.
Only boys?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Mm.
And my sister, including my sister, yeah.
Yeah, it's like they looked up and they were like, hey. Oh, no, but I'm loving this. Is there a name for this group?
The name of the group is Shakti Vale Tiger Dramas.
Shakti Vale Tiger Dramas.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Now, when are you going to send me a video of how you'll actually perform? I didn't get to see this.
I'll ask my sister to send it to you later. Or this, you can go find us on TikTok.
Can find him on TikTok. Yeah. How's that one? Well done, Kesavan. We are so proud of you. Continue reaching for the stars. Lots of love, Uncle Verlin, Auntie Kubash, and Aiden. Vanakam Rebdi, we would like to wish our talented cousin all the best. Remain as awesome as you are. We love you lots. Tons of hugs. Love from your cousins, Swatishka and Saisha. I like that name. And why do I feel like I have interviewed these children before? Because I know these names. Definitely. Another voice note from Aiden. I'm loving this. I love your attention, Aiden.
No, Bhati. Now I'm jealous. If you come to Tongat, I want you to bake the delicious carrot cake I saw on your Facebook page.
Oh, God. Okay, all right. I promise I will bake the carrot cake for you. I'll make poorly for Kesavan. And when I'm coming to Tongat, I will definitely visit you as well. How can I forget you? I will definitely... Don't have to be jealous. God, such big words. Beautiful platform, Revdi. Youth Unplugged, Vanakkam. Awesome, great, and inspiration to the future youth and how to excel incorporating cultural roots too. Of course, parents play that great role mentoring and molding their children. God bless them too. Mikkanandri Revdi, Nirmala Devi Mudli from Gauteng. Thank you so much, ma'am. I actually missed you. I remember you messaged me for the first time on that Saturday before I could actually go on leave. And as well, you had very kind things to say. So thank you so much, ma'am, all the way from Gauteng. You know, the youth are going through a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, one of the things that worries me, we are sitting around 59% youth unemployment in this country.
Yes.
What's your advice? You know, you've got a group happening. You know the challenges. You know, let's just only talk about Tongat. You know the challenges that are happening in Tongat, what the youth are facing. One of the reasons for you to create that group was obviously to get them off the challenges that they are facing, like drugs and all that. What's the top challenge right now? Because from the last time I understood bullying and drug abuse were, you know, very big, rife issues. What right now is Tongat's youth's biggest challenge?
I think it's mostly dealing with drugs and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the kidnapping of children. And
so kidnapping is a big thing?
Yeah.
Okay, now that's the new element to it, because when I was there, it was drugs and drug abuse, because drugs being so freely available to mm-hmm. the youngsters in Tongat yeah. and them consuming it. Kidnapping.
Mm-hmm.
So my understanding, because I'm following these quite closely, and between September to December, for example, one province, and that is Gauteng, they had 77 kidnappings within that 3 months, sure. of which a portion were actually, some of those youngsters were used for human trafficking across our borders.
Mm-hmm.
So how bad is kidnapping right now in Tongat?
We only get to hear about it now and then.
Yeah,
It never like really spread.
Is
very
are
big.
They finding these youngsters or even people?
No, they actually find them.
They find them.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's thank God for that. They're yeah. actually finding them, because yeah, it's an actual. Usually, when I talk to the youngsters, the counselors from all areas, suicide, teen pregnancy, substance abuse, all of these are top challenges.
Yeah.
But something that's come on the cards right now that I've been reading this week, because it is quite rife in India as well.
Mm.
And being the nosy person I am, when I was in India, I was like trying to figure out, okay, what's happening with the youth here? What's the old issues? And very similar. And trafficking, human trafficking and kidnapping is actually on the rise in South Africa. So my advice to all the youngsters out there, please be careful. I know, especially the teenagers, you want to go out with your friends, you want to enjoy yourself, no problem. You don't have to change it. But make sure you send a live location if you feel a bit unsafe. That's the biggest, that's the easiest thing right now.
Yeah.
I was actually feeling a bit unsafe at one point in Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
We had to go from point A to point B. I had to take the Uber with the three others. And just to be safe,
yeah.
I sent the coordinator of our group our live location.
Okay.
That's the easiest thing that you can do, is send your parents, your brother, anyone for that matter, your live location, and let them know that you are safe. Always, you know, communicate. I'm here, I'm doing this. And also, if a place looks a bit dodgy and stuff, try to avoid it. There's so many things. The kutis out there, try not to take things from strangers. When you are talking to someone, there's so many things that we have to teach us. And I would like to take this opportunity to ask all parents, and I know you all are doing a fantastic job, and to all the real Vathis out there, the teachers of all the schools and the principals that have told me they're tuning in this morning, is please take 5 minutes in the day just to let your kids know, not the harsh reality, but how to be street savvy. How to be savvy when they are going maybe to the shop. And if needed, especially the minors, you know, I know it's not easy, but this is where kidnappings are starting, when the minors are taking a walk to the tuck shop and they are getting, you know, abducted there. So try to avoid that. There's so much that's happening right now, and we just need to be extra vigilant, you know, in keeping our kids safe. Namaskaram, Revdi. Namaskaram, Michelle. I'm shocked. The sun rose in the west. What happened, Michelle? I trust you're well. Hope you had a great holiday. I know personally I have tuned in after a very long time. Welcome back. Thank you. Michelle is the youth, I would say, ambassador leader for the Andhra Mahasabha, and I'm very proud of him. I always say that. I'm still waiting for my youngsters from the Andhra community, Michelle. I know you're listening, but I'm very humbled to know that you've tuned in after a very long time. Vanakkam Revdi to my baby brother, Kesavan. Yes, indeed, you are a little troublesome. We will talk about that in a minute. Interviews may be tough and leave you feeling nervous, but your talent and focus will win. I'm extremely sorry I'm unable to be by your side today, but remember, I'll always have your back no matter what, especially being your chorus singer always until I get replaced. Oh, that day will come soon where that pretty girl is going to stand next to him and give chorus. We know that, Krinal. We know that's going to happen. Lots of love from your one and only sister, Krinal. Oh, she's so sweet. I must say, she's got this mum vibe as well to her. She's got your back, that's for sure. But lots and lots of love in that one message that I can see. Now, why she says you're troublesome? Because you're sitting here all professional, and you're such a nice child, and you created this group, but no one's telling me about the problems you're creating in
Tamil. I think she's talking about me irritating her singing the whole day, nonstop.
Why, man?
And I went to bed.
So much that people can take of you in the house.
I went to bed last night, and then she was suffering with a back pain and stuff, and I couldn't. I just couldn't stop talking. And she just fell off to sleep.
Were you practicing to come here?
I was nervous from last night, actually.
Why were you nervous? It's not like you don't know me. The last time I saw you, you were the one who was screaming, "Hi, Revdi Akka," and I was like, "Hey, how are you?" And now you're telling me you're nervous. If you came on any other show, any other station, you don't know the people. It's different. Mm-hmm. Don't you know me? We had a big conversation. You won 6 Sriram tickets from me, man. No, but I'm very proud of you, and very proud of her, actually. I am really, it's outstanding that she has so much of time for you. And I'm, how old is she, by the way?
She's going to be 24.
She's still my youth. She's still a youth, but I like her vibe and the responsibility towards you. Vanakkam Revdi, wishing Kavi. Ooh, is that your nickname?
Yeah, that's my nickname.
Why you didn't tell me? You're making me say Kavyasin all the time.
Sorry.
But I said Homi, I said Kavi. All the best with his career and future endeavors. Lots of love from Priya Atha and Karuna Appa. And wishing my nephew Kavyasin everything of the best. May he reach great heights. Murugan's blessings with you always. See how when you say that, I just automatically smile. From your auntie Shivani from Tongat. We're going to take some music. And when we are back, we're going to chat to him. And we're going to get Kavi to maybe sing for us. It is now 25 minutes to the hour. This is the Youth Unplugged show. Revdi Pillai is the name. Going to be keeping you company from now right up until 12 p.m. today, only on Southside FM 107.2. We are in conversation with Kavi Govinda. I'm going to start calling you Kavi. It's just easier too. It's nice. Okay. Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
I have to ask permission.
I'm fine with that.
You're fine with that. Okay, so Kavi, I hear that you sing.
Mm-hmm.
Can you sing for us?
Okay.
You can. Am I going to ask too much about Asparasa Sriram song?
No, not really.
Just two lines. I don't ask for more. Not max two lines okay. of any Sriram song you like. I like any song too, so it's fine. No need to feel nervous. I'll cut down my bed music. For
okay. నిన్ను చూస్తూ ఉన్నే కన్నున రుందే దిప్పేస్తావే నీ చూపలపైనే రప్పన వేసి కప్పేస్తావే కనిపించని దేవున్నే కన్నార్పక చూస్తావే కన్నున ఎనతే నేనుంతే కాదర్తున్నావే చూపే పంహారమాయినే శివల్లి మాతే మాణిక్యమాయినే చూపే బంగారమాయినే శివల్లి
For a Govinda boy, the way that Telugu runs on your tongue, it sounded awesome.
Thank
beautiful.
You.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I know you've got quite a lot of fans. When you start singing, I know the whole of Tongat will listen to you. But I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. I know you're going to do well, because what I love about your energy and your vibe is that you believe in yourself,
yeah.
you believe in your talent, and the most important thing is very important in life, because we don't actually achieve things on our own.
Mm-hmm.
I am not sitting here today because I made it myself.
Mm.
I've got a support system at home,
yeah.
my friends, people who have challenged me, and I am sitting here today because of them as well. And the fact that you've got such a great support system that I've decided to even come in person today
yeah.
Is amazing. So
yeah.
I would like to say a big thank you to them, because without them, you would have not been able to you know, achieve all that.
Sure.
And also the pretty girl that Krinel, that is sitting in our friend's birthday or rather wedding. Yeah, I think she's also plays an instrumental role
sure.
from what I am seeing for the first time.
Yes.
So yeah, hats off to all of you. I'm loving this. I know, as someone who takes a vested interest in youngsters and wanting to make sure that we can empower them on the show, and even just chatting to them, I get emotional when I see that a child has such great support system.
Yeah.
Because it really saddens me when I do see a lot of youngsters say, you know what, I want to do this, Revdi, I want to do that. There's a child that actually told me, I want to work in NASA one day.
Yo.
But not every child has that luxury of having a support system.
Yes.
So if you know of a youngster and, you know, that has that dreams, and you can see that they don't have a very strong support system.
Mm.
And I want you to take this back to the 13 other boys and your sister and yourself in the group. Or not only do you know you must venture into music,
yes.
try to encourage each other and spread that word, that chain, you know, create that chain about once a month, talking about something motivational and how you can actually take it out there. You're now on TikTok.
Yeah.
So I'm giving you homework, okay. right? Homework once a month. I won't burden your TikTok handle.
Yeah.
And I know you've got a set audience
okay.
that like what you all do. I know you kids on TikTok. So just once a month, get everybody together and do a video, a motivational video.
Okay.
And you'll never believe some youngster that just swipes and sees your video that's really feeling down in the dumps might just get better.
Yeah.
So So that's my homework to you, right?
Okay.
I'm waiting to see the link being WhatsApp to
okay.
you.
I'll definitely.
All right. Namaskaram. A special shout out to Segri of Golden Oldies Montfort. Thanks. Have a great day, Geetha Birbal. This one comes from, Geetha. Geetha, I like your DP. It's got an absolutely adorable little baby there as well with your pretty face. Wow, well done to your youth, Revdi, today, Revdi. Beautiful voice and sounded absolutely awesome. All the best for your future, young man. Comes from Kamala. See, I told you, you're getting a fan base. What's your handle on TikTok?
I actually lost one of my accounts. I had 1.6k followers.
We start again. That's life. Don't stress.
Yeah.
When you do,
but,
what's your handle right now?
My aim is not really to get fame. It's just to earn respect.
That is what I love about you, and I love what you said, because I believe in that 200%. A lot of people ask me, Revdi, why don't you have a TikTok account? Mm-hmm. Why you don't post anything?
Yeah.
I don't have the intention of wanting to be out there and be famous. Mm. Why I chose radio is because clearly I was mistaken. Now I'm on Facebook because I thought I'm going to sit in a small room, and which I was sitting in initially, and it's just me, the mic, and the muckle that's going to communicate with me, and it all they had to do was hear me out. That's it. You would never see me put a picture out in a hurry.
Yeah.
It took, I remember, Mishantan, 4 months to get a picture out of me for the breakfast show.
Sure.
Because he asked, and I repeatedly, I cannot pose. I don't want to take a picture. But that's who I was, and that's the type of person that I was. It's like, I don't, and I still believe in that. If I can make one child happy, which I'm hoping I made you happy today, that's my aim. And even if today on radio, tomorrow, wherever I am, that's the aim. Yeah. My dream is to have an orphanage with at least 100 children.
Yeah.
And if I can make a difference in their lives, I can make 100 kids better. Yeah. That's all that I want to do. It seriously have been my dream for the past maybe 9 years now.
Yeah.
And I always say, if I win the lotto, or I just need to continue working and I can save up to build it, whether it's in this country, anywhere for that matter, just to help 100 kids, because I see the stresses that the youngsters are going through. It is not nice. There's certain things that I can't even say on air. That's the type of challenges that they are facing. And talking about that, 1 minute, let's see. Vanakkam Revdi, I would like to congratulate the governors. I know Bully and Verlin. Who's Bully?
My dad's other name.
Oh, okay. You've got a few names. And Verlin, when they were small boys, and to see their sunshine brings joy to my heart. Well done. You're now making your thoughts like me proud. Aww. Emo moment. This one comes from Aiden. Aiden sends that through. So I can see the tiger drumming and all of that. It's been in the family for I've seen videos of it, but I haven't seen it actually, or maybe it was a very young, but I haven't seen it in person, maybe in the past 5-6 years. I have not, or maybe even nearly 10 years, I haven't seen it in person.
Okay.
So the next time y'all are doing something, please invite me. I'd like to see this. I'm very curious. Okay. Because when I watched it on my phone, I was like, wow, that is skill.
Yeah.
That is skill. There's different types of drumming and stuff like that, but that with the fire and stuff.
Yeah.
I have to ask a question. Do you all get burnt when you all do it?
No, we don't actually do fire dancing.
Okay.
It's just drumming.
It's just the drumming.
Just drumming.
Because I saw that, and with the drumming, they had fire as well. I'm like, oh my word.
Yeah.
Are they not getting hurt, or they're not getting burnt? Okay, they don't.
Uh-uh.
Okay, that was very scary. We're going to take some more music, and when we come back, we're going to be saying bye-byes to Kesavan, Kavi, and thereafter I'm going to be talking to you about a topic that's been worrying me. It happened in India. I refuse to celebrate International Women's Day on the 8th of March in India. I received my certificate from the government in Delhi that day. It was a day to be proud, because I received my certification in journalism and public relations on that day, but I didn't want to post it because everybody was wishing everyone. But a tragedy had struck there, and I started to investigate the stats here, and I was not happy, and I told myself, I'm not wishing anyone, even on the 9th of August, until we start to make a difference in every girl's life. But we'll talk about that when I come back.
The youth of SA is indeed the future of this country. It is an absolute privilege for me to host a show to tackle the current challenges and opportunities that affect them. As a youngster, there are many decisions that pave the way for the future. This show is aimed at supporting the youth and encouraging them to make that decision. You can join me, Revdi Pillay, every Saturday between 9 to 12 as I bring four topics of interest. Remember, this is a show for the youth, by the youth.
என் கூட வர கேட்ட நிலவைய கையோட நீ குட்டி வரடி என் மதர் ப்ராமிஸ் போட்ட நான் உன்ன தர மாட்டேன் நீ உள்ள வந்தா கண்ணுக்குள்ள வச்சுக்கிறடி உன்ன பத்தி பேசும் போதே தித்திக்கு தேடி உன் பேரெழு தொங்க பாடலாம் பத்திக்கு தேடி என் மாமா மச்சா எல்லாம் இனி பிரிட்டிஷ்காரன் தானா நீ லவ் சொல்ல சப்டைட்டில் நான் போட்டுக்கிறடி பிம்பிலுக்கு பிம்பிலுக்கு பிள்ளாப்பி இத நம்ம லாமா வானாமா டி ஜிலேபி தாண்டி பார்த்த என் கூட வர கேட்ட நில பய கையோட நீ குட்டி வரடி என் மதர் ப்ராமிஸ் போட்ட நான் உன்ன தர மாட்டேன் நீ உள்ள வந்தா கண்ணுக்குள்ள வச்சுக்கிறடி
One of my favorite songs, I have to admit. I couldn't stay quiet during this time. It is now 12 minutes to the hour. And welcome back to the Youth Unplugged show. This is your Bharti Revdi Pillay here with you till 12 p.m. today. Right, we are at that time of the show, during that time where we are going to actually be entering our last hour in the next 10 minutes. But we are going to now be saying our bye-byes to Kavi, who is our Youth of the Week today on this beautiful sunny Saturday in Chatswood. I love the breeze that I'm seeing. I get a good view. I see a lot of glass doors in front of me and lots of trees and a good view as well of most of Chatswood there. If you can, you know, see, ask me which unit. I don't know. It's a good view. Definitely. So on this day, Kavi, I know you've got some dedications and some shout outs and all of that. So the floor is all yours, my dear.
Okay, so firstly, I would like to give a big thank out to my mom for motivating me in this music journey. And second of all, there's more. I'd like to give a thank out to the Mason Shri Ampir Ma Prayer Group, the Tamil, Tonga Tamil Academy, for allowing me to go into Eisteddfod and go and take part and be one of you all. And mainly my two gurus, when I firstly started with the full-on service and bhajan and going into music, Guru Kirtan Karthikeyan Pillai and Tavyasan Fariyachi. Yeah. And lastly, before I leave, I would like to give a dedication to all those who are celebrating and observing Pangani Uttaram Kavadi.
Yes, no, definitely. I'd like to actually, while he's on that note, I'd like to wish every youngster out there and family and friend that I know, firstly, a blessed Ramadan Kareem to every single one of you during this holy month. May Allah bless every single one of you. May your dreams, wishes, all that you are fasting for during this month come true, and may your homes be filled with happiness. And thank you for being there for each another, and for me, to all my friends Solibai and all of them, a blessed Ramadan month fasting. And to all those that are celebrating Panguni Uttiram, a blessed Panguni Uttiram to you. It will take place on Sunday, starting the Uttiram Nachitram, coinciding with the Paurnami star. That Tidhi should start on Sunday, just after morning time, and go into Monday morning. So for those who are observing, may Murugan bless you with all the happiness in the world, and make sure that on that day you do some kind of annadanam. And annadanam means, even if it's buying a bottle of water, or even if it's a plate of food, just share it with someone who's in need. Because out of everything, the biggest punyam that you can do in this lifetime, they say, is feeding someone who is hungry. So to all those out there, make sure you do that on a very blessed day like Panguni Uttiram. Got a voice note, yeah? I like her. I just play them. I didn't vet them, but let's see.
Hello, Kavis and Anna. You make us so proud. You hope you enjoy your day. From Swasti, and I love you. Bye.
She's got so much of energy and she's rushing somewhere. But who's that?
That's my cousin sister.
Okay, cousin sister. I'm loving her vibe. I'm going to ask her why she didn't come on the show as yet. Hi, Revdi. Not sure why randomly the transmission is cutting. I don't know, unfortunately. That comes from the Sharan Reddy. The rest of you can let me know if it's okay now. If it's not, then to the technical team that are listening, please can you check? But I do have that reported now. But remember, if 107.2 is giving you a problem, you can stream us on one of my favorite platforms, Radio Garden, or on www.southsidefm.com. My picture is not there as yet. I don't know why. I did that beautiful poses at Photogenic, but I don't see it there as yet. So if you go there, you will see it. Mervyn Kirsten, Vanakkam, please give me a name of the film and who sings the song. Thank you. I will have a look at it whilst I play the song. So he's forwarded a video and he wants to know the name of it. We will definitely get that for you. And we're going to take some more music. And once again, Kavi, thank you. On behalf of Youth Unplugged, your Bharti Revdi Pillai, I want to say firstly, I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
I'm very proud of what you've achieved thus far. All the best in school. And grade 12, you're going to rock it. I know that.
Thank you.
And remember, for all the youngsters that you are associated with in Tongaat, even yourself, if you all are having any challenges, remember, there's always someone that you can speak to, whether it's your family, whether it's the Youth Unplugged WhatsApp number, you can talk to me, anything. But remember, you all are not alone.
Yeah.
There's always someone that you can talk to. And you all are real heroes for going through what Tongaat is going through with regards to the water.
Yeah.
Kavi, you forgot to thank Dad for transporting and being your support, and Dada for supporting you.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes, please carry on.
I
was waiting while she was quiet. Okay, yes.
Yeah. I would also like to thank my dad for transporting me everywhere and for carrying me when I was a baby with my drum running around from one side to the other.
Oh, my word. Okay.
Yeah, so before I leave, this is a dedication for all those observing Pangani Uttaram Kavadi.
Okay.
ಕಂದ ಮುರುಗ ವರುವಾಯೇ ಶಾಂತಿ ಪೆರವೇ ಅರುವಾಯೇ ಕಂದ ಮುರುಗ ವರುವಾಯೇ ಶಾಂತಿ ಪೆರವೇ ಅರುವಾಯೇ ಕನಮೇರಂ ವಾರಾಯ ದೇವಮೇ ಕನ್ನಾರ್ ಕಂದಾಯ್ ಪೋದುಮೇ ಕನಮೇರಂ ವಾರಾಯಂದೇವಮೇ ಕನ್ನಾರ್ ಕಂದಾಯ್ ಪೋದುಮೇ ತುನೆಯಾಗಿ ವರುವಾಯನದಾರಿ ವಾಳ್ವೇ ತುನೆಯಾಗಿ ವರುವಾಯನದಾರಿ ಹುರಿಯರೇ ನೀ ಸುನ್ನಪಡಿಯೇ ನಾಲಾಡುವೆ ನೀ ಸುನ್ನಪಡಿಯೇ ನಾಲಾಡುವೆ ಮುರುಗ 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 ವಡಿವೇಲ ಕಂದ ಮುರುಗ ಹರುಹರ ಪರ್ಣೆ ಮಲೆ ಗಿರಿವಾಸ ಷಣ್ಮುಗನಾದ ಓರಿವ ಕಾರ್ತಿಗೆಯ ಪಾಡುವಾನ್ ಸೆಂದಿಲ್ನಾದ ನಾಡುವಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ತಿಗೆಯ ಪಾಡುವಾನ್ ಸೆಂದಿಲ್ನಾದ ನಾಡುವಾನ್
ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ I really enjoyed that rendition. Really did. All the very best and may God bless you. And yeah, just enjoy what you do. That's what I can see why you're loving it. You just enjoy what you do. And I can see how emo you get when you sing for Murugan. This is the Youth Unplugged Show. We'll be back. And then we're going to be chatting about Let's Get Real, a topic that is really, really stressing me, guys. And I'm hoping to get your input on it. The youth of SA is indeed the future of this country. It is an absolute privilege for me to host a show to tackle the current challenges and opportunities that affect them. As a youngster, there are many decisions that pave the way for the future. This show is aimed at supporting the youth and encouraging them to make that decision. You can join me, Revdi Pillai, every Saturday between 9 to 12 as I bring four topics of interest. Remember, this is a show for the youth, by the youth.
Cute ponne, follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me. Hatchukula, allow me, allow me, allow me, allow me. Cute ponne, follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me. Hatchukula, allow me, allow me, allow me, allow me, allow me.
Follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me.
Okay, it is now 11 o'clock on the dot on Youth Unplugged, and welcome back to the show. Revati Pillai is the name. We in the last hour of the show, making me very sad, but what's also making me very sad is a topic that I want to chat about, but just going to finish off with these messages. Awesome voice, may Lord Murugan bless you with your music career, says Rubeshni. Dina Naidu says, welcome back, nice to hear your voice and laughs. Sins Naika, Vanakam Revati, good to hear your voice, have a blessed day, love you lots. And let's see what else we have here. Revati, you're doing a sterling job of empowering youth. God bless with all your future endeavors. Rubesh Nian says, welcome back and well done, Kavi. Vanakam Revati, welcome back, says Selvi Naidu. And Saloshni says the same. And as Rani Naika also does, says the same. So remember, you can actually view us on our Facebook page. That is Southside FM, South Africa. Now, on the 2nd of March, and this is actually a topic that no one really likes to talk about, but according to stats, as of 2021-2022, there has been 43,000, plus minus 43,000 rape cases in this country. In the stats showing me as of facts, right, in the year 2021-2022, that was the stats that I looked up, okay? And if you're looking at it to be exact, it is females who are likely to be affected by abduction, rape, sexual assault, child trafficking, and attempted common robbery. And that is why I call this segment, let's get it real here, that we're talking about, is because definitely it affects both genders. But the total that has happened of that 43,000, 90% were female, 10% was male. Rape cases, 90% were female, 10% was male. Assault, 88%. Child trafficking, 74% was female, 26% were male. Child trafficking. Now, these are stats that are showing in South Africa. On the 2nd of March, if you go on to Instagram, you will see Puducherry in south of India had a case of rape and murder on a 9-year-old child. Now, when I read that, it worried me sick. And as I said, it took them 5 days. And around the 8th of March, when India celebrated International Women's Day, this child's body was found. And that is what is stressing me, because this is happening in our backyards. This is happening in and around our communities. 43,000 cases of assault abductions is not a joke that's happening in our country. I mean, you've got a sister at home.
Yes. And, you know, I relate to it because, my parents are grateful that I'm there to see to her. Mm. You know, they're working and I take care of her school needs. Take her to school, pick her up, take her to tuitions.
Yeah.
And the main thing is I don't let her go anywhere without us.
Yeah.
Because of the same reasons. It's a reality, you know.
It's a reality.
People say, you know, you're overthinking it or whatever, but you don't know what will happen.
Yeah. You're not overthinking
exactly.
It.
Exactly. It's my instinct.
It's not setting a fear. We're not talking about it because we want to instill fear. No. I am talking about it because as a concerned citizen, as someone like the muckle that have given me a title of Vati, and being a youth ambassador, I work with kids. I work with all of these innocent kids, and to know that these stats are happening. So if you go hashtag justice for Aarti, that is the child in Puducherry that was murdered, and it was six youngsters, they minors themselves, of which one was her relative.
Wow.
And that is the sad reality of what had happened. And when I came back home and I was going more into the stats, this is what I actually found, that we are, yes, you know, quite rife in it as well. Now, I had conversations with many people about it, and many people gave me, talks about should we have harsher, strict punishments? Should there be more awareness made? For me, and I must say a sterling job to every parent out there that's doing their best, my request to you right now, and I know that all the households are doing it, and even, you know, I might not have kids, but I talk to my nephews as well.
take 5 minutes. For me, I always say what's within your control is what you look after. What's not within your control, like the justice system, you cannot do anything about it right now. Yes. So with all this, the unsafe activities and the issues that, you know, our, especially as you can see, 90% is what's happening to the females when it comes to rape, when it comes to sexual assault. We need to sit our youngsters and especially the male, the kids in our families for 5 minutes a day, just by telling them, simple, no means no.
Yes.
No means no. When a girl says no, she means no. And when you look at a female, have the same respect at how you would look at your mum, how you would look at someone you already respect. It goes for girls as well. No means no. And when you look at a guy, have the same respect for him that you see, you know, in the men in your life that you already have that respect for. You need to, I feel, and I will do that with my child one day, is take a 5 minutes every day and just tell them, instill that in them. Because why I say that is all our kids are growing up. I mean, no one taught me this. It's in, you know, in the way we were brought up. But psychologically, if you make it a lesson, the child will then grow up to take it and teach it to others.
Yes, and it will be instilled in them and forthcoming, yeah.
Yes, so that for me is very important. You know, I will not post anything on the 9th of August this year until I see a drop in that stats. I seriously am now tired of us celebrating women on one day, but having to deal with the issues like this where you are not safe enough to go out to enjoy yourself or just be, or go to the tuck shop or go to school with the minors, because that's where they're getting abducted. Being left with relatives sometimes is also not safe. The type of cases that you hear in the news when you read on IOL or anyway for that matter.
And also I feel like, you know, technology also plays a very big role in also that as well. So I also feel, you know, it's just my opinion, but I feel that, you know, as youngsters, like younger than my age, the technology that the kids use of these days should be really controlled, you know? But
You see, unfortunately, with the way the world is going and
technology is advancing,
everything is AI, and really you can't hold a child back from, coming from an IT background, I can tell you, you can't hold a child back so much from technology, because they need it. It's become a necessity to actually have as they are growing older, because some schools are already using for long now iPads. When you go to college, you need it.
Yes.
You need to know about social media, and but it's all about using it for the right reason.
Correct.
Example, TikTok. I know a lot of youngsters that do create videos, but stand out and create a video that's different.
Yes.
I've seen Instagram pages as well. Stand out and
even Facebook pages,
different.
Same story, yeah.
Yeah, but you know, you're mostly the youngsters is between IG and TikTok, and that's what I say. Rubeshni Mudali says, well said, Revdi, it starts with us as parents. No, definitely. As I said, it's my most humble request to whoever's listening right now, whoever's tuned in on Facebook, anyone for that matter, is my humble request. I was absolutely saddened, sickened by what I saw happen during that week in March when I was there. And by just putting up stats now, I've got a niece, I'm afraid, and she's quite young. So how do you keep them safe? And the only way possible that I know that is within our control is, please take 5 minutes. And also to the real Vathis out there, the teachers, the principals, I know guidance counselors have been taken away from schools, but take it upon yourself, spread the word. You know, it's important that we tell our youngsters, no means no. Respect someone else, respect their body, respect who they are. And I'm sure if we just continuously instill that, we will have a generation to come that will feel safer. There will be no need for the government to even create harsher conditions.
Correct.
Corrections and all of that, because we will already have the mindset. I always say, we tackle suicide, but why are we tackling suicide when that's the end result? Something triggered for suicide to actually happen.
There's other intermediate things, yeah.
Exactly. So things like depression, things like this, bullying, cyberbullying, all of that. nip it at the bud by changing the behavior. And when it comes to rape and sexual assault, it all definitely, for me personally, my opinion, it's behavior. It's how the individual sees the other one, you know, the victim, and how they, you know, want to pursue this. But if we teach our kids from now, please respect each another. No means no. It will definitely work. Rubeshni continues to say 100% technology is a necessity in the values and ethics we instill in our kids and encourage our kids to stand out, be an individual. I agree. You know, in school, I remember I used to have issues where, you know, kids didn't want to play with me.
Yeah.
Grade 3. Didn't want to play with me because I didn't, from that age, I don't know why, I didn't want to follow like sheep. If they all were doing something and if I didn't want to do it, I wasn't part of the cool clan, fine. But I always stood my ground. And I always say this, be an individual. Don't follow what someone else is doing. Don't just follow a group because it's cool to do so. Don't mimic something. Just be you. Find your originality. I, for example, will not go and do a show that is not in my, you know, not my forte, not my strength.
Yes.
This is my strength, hence I do it. Likewise, do something and know your strength. Like Rubeshni says, you know, kids need to do something that will stand out. Take your TikTok account, open it up, do a video, but do something different that's going to make a difference.
Unique is now the new cool, basically.
I'm hoping that they actually make it the new cool. Be proud to be happy in your own skin. And that also goes with, you know, with body shaming as well. Just be happy to be you. I know I'm not a size 30. I'm not ideal. I've got my cheeks and I'm very proud of it. I'm very happy in my own skin because there's someone out there that's going through an above knee amputation, who's going through to some type of amputation for their limb. And the part of your body that you are saying, I don't like it anymore, that person just lost it in the hospital. So that's...
And they would kill for it.
They would kill for it. Just look after yourself. Be healthy, but look after yourself. But don't go to the point of not liking yourself because of peer pressure. Just be you. I know it's not easy, especially to all the youngsters that's listening right now. But at the end of the day, this is just a phase. It will pass. And at the end of the day, what I'm saying now will definitely make sense to you by the time you come to my age. And then you'll thank me for it. But just be uniquely you and never be, you know, don't be afraid to be you as well. But most importantly, before we take some music, it really, really worries me. And I'm going to continue talking about it next Saturday as well. And in time to come, on and off air, we need to make sure we teach our kids no means no. And change the behavior at that foundation level. So we will be able to curb this. As a community, we can curb the rape cases in our communities. We can. I am sure we can. Yes, we cannot do anything about the adults that are committing this terrible crimes right now. Definitely God will give them a punishment. And I'm hoping the system as well does so. But to all those toddlers that's in your house, to all those teenagers that are in your house, you still have time to strengthen that bond with them and to tell them that no means no. We're going to take some music, and when we come back, we're going to be talking about it in more detail.
Ordinary people creating extraordinary experiences. It's Youth Unplugged on Southside FM 107.2.
I'm
mama 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 heza nemu mumu mumu sabai taba cheza mama 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 heza nemu mumu mumu sabai taba cheza
Ordinary people creating extraordinary experiences. It's Youth Unplugged on Southside FM 107.2.
A big hello to all of you. Hi, this is your Karthik here, and you are listening to me on Southside FM with Revati Pillai. Loads and loads of love from me to all of you out there. I'll see you guys soon.
அவ்வொரு மாலை இளவெயில் நேரம் அழகான இளையுதிர் காலம் சற்று தொலைவிலே அவள் முகம் பார்த்தேன் அங்கே தோன்றே சற்று தொலைவிலே அவள் முகம் பார்த்தேன் அங்கே தோன்றே
is the voice of Karthik Urumale from the movie Gajini, one of Surya's best movies, I would say. He did an excellent job and Karthik just outdid himself in that. We are away right now that there is a break in transmission. Seriously, from an RJ's point of view, thank you so much for telling me. I'm sure that the relevant people are doing something to sort it out. But if you cannot get me on 107.2, remember for those who are streaming who can, and for those who are listening on our Facebook page, which actually helps because if you get to know what's really happening real time right now. But for those who are watching our Facebook page, Southside FM South Africa, know that apparently there is a break in transmission, but you can stream us on www.southsidefm.com or on Radio Garden for that matter. Now, I have to tell you all about my holiday.
I can't wait. It seems very exciting. I've seen the posts. I've been waiting for this.
Rani, I'm aware of it. Thank you so much, Michelle. I'm aware of it. But I must say, you guys are too cute and too sweet. They're letting me know when there's an issue. But I really don't know what's the issue. But continue to listen to me on other platforms, I'm assuming. I went on an iTech program.
Okay.
And it is something that was sponsored by the Ministry of External Affairs in Delhi in conjunction with the Consulate General of India in South Africa, Dr. Thelma John Davis. And it was an absolutely exciting journey. So I went on a course in Hyderabad at the Marichana Institute, HRD, Institute of the Telangana State, and that was in Hyderabad. For 1.5 weeks, we thought it was a course on a certification on journalism and public relations.
Okay.
So they taught us about journalism and how to do good journalism. And they taught us about public relations and all of that. So it was absolutely informative. Mornings till about just before lunch, we had classroom settings. And there were 30 of us that we selected from all media houses. And we had a nice time learning all of these. The professors were your NDTV anchors.
Wow.
Your Times of India professors. So these people that came, one of the professors, Mr. Panjang, was a former advisor to the Prime Minister.
Okay.
A then Prime Minister. So it was quite informative. You're getting first-hand good knowledge. They were very well and versed in South Africa and our politics. So that was great to know that, you know, they knew their type of audience. But I must say, I think I can talk on behalf of all my colleagues that actually went, is we learned quite a lot from them.
I can imagine. So, and your course that you did, was it like a whole day thing or was it just half the day?
It was half a day. So you're actually learning sometimes the whole day. So it was quite a lot. Lucky there was no homework. You do everything. I'm so bad at homework. But yeah, we did like one day. It was about knowing journalism and in the rural areas. And the best one, I think it was the third day, I went to India's first community radio called Sangam Radio.
Okay.
Sangam Radio is opened and still managed by rural women in the Telangana state.
Wow.
So the very first community radio is in the Telangana state, opened a long time ago now, over 80 years, and they have been, this is called Sangam Radio. What I love about them is they go and they talk to the farmers and they talk about agriculture. And they are growing millet and they talk about the health benefits all in their own native language. It's something like Telugu, but it's actually a bit of a different slang. So very difficult to understand them. It's a really rural area with only farming. There's no shops, nothing. So you are walking and it's about around a square meter of about 150,000 people live there.
Yo.
And that's a small village. You must understand, India has 1.7.
It's a big population,
people.
Yeah.
When we went to Delhi and he said, we've got 35 million people. And I looked at him and we've got about 62 million. And that's
around there, yeah.
And that's our population for the whole country.
So, <Sure. laughs>
So he looked at me and he laughed. He was like, oh, I was like, yeah. That was in Invest India where they taught us about investments and how India is going to be coming up. But it was quite informative. I think my favorite part was in Hyderabad. And I'm so happy I stayed there for 1.5 weeks. We went to Golconda Fort, not only the community radio station. So Golconda Fort, whoever watched Sri Ramadasu?
Yes.
Ramadasu was kept for 14 years. Golconda Fort was the place. They showed us that he was kept there for that 14 years and then he was released. So it was a very emotional one for me because I knew the story, and the fact that all of that happened with Sri Ram there was very interesting. Chamina, which is another iconic place, which has a very big bazaar with lots of shops around it. That is Hyderabad's center there. We went to Tea Hub, and that is the world's biggest innovation center when it comes to IT. Hyderabad, for me personally, puts everybody away when it comes to IT.
Wow.
When
are they
I
that
talk
technically
technology,
advanced?
They are called the technical hub of the country. Of the entire country. So I was absolutely fascinated. And I was like a child in a toy store when I went there. And every single thing that they had about IT was amazing. We went there. Then there was many areas that we went. It was more, you know, iconic places. UNESCO agreed places. There was one Shiva temple where the earthquake actually shattered everything. But his temple and Nandi still stands because of science. If you take a brick from his gopuram and you place it in water, it will float. And because of their technology, the earthquake didn't affect them. That's one. There's another palace that is outright gone. But you will just see a normal arch of a Shiva, a Hanuman and the Nandi. And that is there because that obviously didn't get destroyed. But it's just as is. I like the fact of how they preserve things.
Yes.
But I must say, it's seriously Hyderabad. You don't see like cows everywhere. It's a typical city. And for me, it felt very much like Durban.
Okay.
So if I had to advise those who are traveling, definitely hit a stop at Hyderabad. I mean, for someone who doesn't know a lot of Telugu, I was able to speak a few lines by the end of it because they speak mainly Telugu and Hindi.
Okay.
So Hindi I'm comfortable with. So I was talking to them in Hindi, and then eventually, you know, I was talking to them about other things and all of that. Even when I used to call home, I used to call my dad, Nana. How are you, Nana? Missing you. He was like, what is this place doing to you? And I was like, no, it's so cool because all the kids scream for Nana.
Yeah, yeah.
So all those words I picked up, and it was absolutely fascinating. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So that was that. And then last few days, we stayed in Delhi because lessons had to take place there. And then on the Friday the 8th, I went to the Minister of External Affairs office and they gave me my certificate to say that I'm now competent. But that was then, thereafter, we went to Agra. That was the only thing I really enjoyed after I went to Delhi. After the buildings and everything was great, but the food was different. I didn't really take to the food in Delhi. But going to Agra was magical. Seriously, it's magical. I mean, even there's signs. The pillars are slightly outward for those who don't really take, you know, detailed attention to it. That's because if
as an architecture student, yeah. I can definitely say that in India, the buildings itself,
it's amazing.
It blows my mind the way they've constructed and done these things. Especially, you know, the prehistoric stuff, like you're talking about the temples.
It's amazing.
Defines the laws of everything that you've learned.
The guy actually showed us on a gopuram. He says, look at this statue, and she's got heels. And he said this was made in 1300. And she's
wow.
got heels, stilettos on.
My goodness.
And now we are walking with it. But it was carved at that time. But even, you know, the Taj Mahal, Shah Jahan ensured that if an earthquake comes, the pillars will fall outwards. So they showed the science behind it of how
okay.
that place will be preserved. But it is very sad that the whole world knows how Shah Jahan loved Mumtaz, but she herself, because obviously she passed on. But the story of how her body was brought there, eventually, you know, he was placed next to her. It is definitely a monument of love.
Okay.
It's very cool inside. You're not allowed to take pictures inside, but when you go around them, it's very cool because of the type of marble that was used. Just behind the Taj Mahal is Yamuna that's flowing.
Yeah.
And who is Yamuna? That's Yama's sister. So the place where he chose to actually build that tomb as such for her, it's amazing. So much of thought actually went into it. So yeah, it's...
And I only have one more question because this is very interesting to me. Right? I'm not
God.
Interviewing
I'm,
Miyaka,
no,
but...
No problem. I like talking.
I'm a big foodie, right? I love food no matter what. What was your favorite... I'm sure there was a meal that you loved or...
But I made them too.
Oh.
So we were staying in a hostel.
Okay.
It was a very nice hostel with the rest of them. And I took to the food. So they had yellow dolakas, dal tadka. I don't eat chicken when I go to India.
Okay.
So I'm a fussy eater. I don't eat red meat and chicken. I'll eat fish.
Okay.
But I hardly ate. I think I just ate it twice. Majority of the time I was a vegetarian. But you have a lot of, they have a lot of paneer, veg curries. They make takali rasam, which is tomato rasam all the time. I had to ask them to make it melaga rasam, a pepper rasam, because I was wanting that. Plus
yeah.
a few of the colleagues were getting a bit tired and a bit you know, low on energy. So I told them, make the rasam and they'll drink it and they'll feel better. But it was actually helping. So you get your rasam, your sambar, all of these. It's very much linked, very close to the normal Tamil Nadu food, but there is still that level of spice that I enjoyed. So it is spicier, but they were cutting it down because not everybody was familiar with
yes.
the spice. But you get your, but they're very big in God biryani. So Hyderabad is noted for their dum biryani. Their dum biryani, their chicken biryani, their lamb biryani and veg. But the mutton and chicken biryani is the biggest. If you go to Hyderabad, they will force you and you have to have biryani. And I'm not going to
eat biryani
the
all the time.
But their biryani is very different from us. So the difference
is it like a palau almost?
No, it's a normal biryani.
Yeah?
But the difference between their biryani and our biryani,
I guess the spices
is,
maybe?
No, it's how they make it. It's putting it in, you know, putting it and making it and then taking a piece of dough and putting it
okay.
around the lid and then sealing it and putting charcoal on top. That's what makes the fiery, smoky flavor.
Oh.
I didn't eat the chicken biryani, obviously, but I tasted the veg one and it was absolutely yummy with raita. But unfortunately, they're so passionate about biryani. If they can give that to you every day, they would.
If my sister and my parents are listening, I think they better know this is where we need to go next.
No, you know, you say that, but at some point you get fed up of the biryani, but the other guys were, because it's not really our biryani.
Yeah, nothing
it's,
can
it's
nothing
a very
can take
different
to it, yeah.
taste and very different flavors are used, but it tastes very nice. But yeah, so I had it about once or twice. They have South Indian, North Indian thalis. That was a savior. They've got fast foods, the takeouts that we have. That was also a savior for many of those that we're not familiar with food. But in Delhi as well, the food is rather your normal butter chicken and all of that. But they're very much sandwiches, that kind of
okay.
Western. You don't always get the curries, but I remember we did go out for dinner as well in a restaurant once. I mean, it was a hotel and they had a good spread, but it was your palaus and all of that. The food is good, but you don't always get it readily available. You must know where to eat in Delhi.
Yeah, I get that, yeah.
The pollution is a killer, I won't lie. I always had a double mask when I was in Delhi. the pollution is really evident there. You can see the air pollution. So they don't lie when they talk about that.
Yeah, I've seen Agra it on TV as well. Yeah,
it's very bad. But Agra was better. Less pollution. Being a tourist destination, they were actually very good.
Okay.
Yeah, so for those youngsters that want to be on this, and including yourself, you know, I think it's an absolutely awesome opportunity that I can tell you, being sponsored by the Consulate General of India in South Africa. This is the ITEC program for working individuals like myself. It was a two-week program. They offer 140 courses. I went on the journalism and public relations one, because obviously that affects me.
Yeah.
But there's so many that you can go to. But for those who would like to be a part of the Know India program, there is also one where they, you know, if you want to excel in your dance or in music, you can go. They are proper. Besides agriculture and medicine, the consulate also offers a fully paid scholarship or a bursary to study a proper degree at one of the universities and come back.
Okay.
Obviously, the way to go about is going on to their website. And thereafter, once you've gone onto the website, choose what you're looking for and even call them and ask them more about
it. And obviously follow the prompts.
The prompts. Right now, I've been the other day, the consulate invited me. They have had an ICCR scholarship for 2024-2025. It's the India-Africa Maitri Scheme, the ICCR Lata Mangeshkar Scheme. Now, this is currently open. You can apply on the A2A portal, which is www.a2ascholarships.iccr.gov.in. It started on the 20th of Feb and it will end on the 30th of April 2024. You can contact them on the email address itec.durban@mea.gov.in, or you can call them on 031-335-0300. So yeah, so that's how you can get a hold of them. I would encourage many out there to actually go for it, apply for it. You gotta have thick skin. Remember, you're not going to be in your mummy's comfort in your bedroom and have all of it. You're living in basic facilities. I think that's what many kids need to realize. You're gonna get your allowance and all of that, but you're gonna be living in a hostel, so that's the realities of it. But they do look after you. At one point, I was missing home, and it was 2 days before I could leave Hyderabad. And a big shout out, because I know he's listening, Nagaraja, who's the chef there. And I told him, Aneya, I want poli. I feel like having poli. This is how I make it. He went and he made the same thing, but the poor thing, he went and he dipped it in syrup and he took it out. So now that's the part we don't do.
Yeah.
But it tasted pretty decent. It had everything but the nuts, but it tasted pretty decent. It was absolutely awesome.
You know, speaking of poli, and I know you were, that's in India. While you were in India, I felt like I was getting deep fried like a poli with this heat.
I heard that. Actually, I was chatting to a few friends and
it was so
36
hot.
Degrees.
I don't know, the sun that I used to play outside with and the sun that's here, I don't know. I think it got something to go out of me.
That's because us as humans, it is the honest truth. Us as humans didn't look after Mother Nature, and now it's what we have to pay for.
Yeah, it's true. Well,
we have to live with it now, because at one point when we shouldn't have littered the ground, when we shouldn't have thrown things into the river, which we are still doing, our sea, we are unable to use our beach because of E. coli and many other issues. We are unable to get clean, fresh water sometimes. We have four seasons in a day. Where did you hear of us having mini cyclones, hurricanes? And if you go onto the
satellite
view,
Durban.
it's satellite view. If you go onto it, there are continuous cyclones emerging.
Yeah, and warnings.
Above.
Yeah.
So that is the new South Africa, unfortunately, when it comes to.
I guess you know when they said what goes around comes around, it actually comes around.
It does. If you don't look after her, she will find it very difficult to look after you. So it is really a give and take situation. And it works like that in relationships. It works like that in anything in life. Look after what you have. Respect. And, you know, if I can just make that appeal, it's never too late. Choose differently. Instead of plastic, choose a glass. If you have a wrapper in your hand, keep it in your pocket until you go to a bin.
But don't be like me. Keep it in the pocket and put it in the washing machine. And then my mother starts shouting at me. When you go home, throw it in the bin.
What's your mother's name?
I'm scared to tell you now. Kamala Govinda.
Kamala Govinda, please empty your son's pockets before you can put it in the machine. That is something that children don't get. So eventually what I do is, you know, I make sure I do it. But when I was a kid, my mother had the habit, just check the pockets because she knows something's going in there that should not go in there. So that happens. Don't worry. Don't stress. Joyce, very good morning to you, Joyce. Vati, Revdi, my gorgeous sister, Vanikam. I missed your voice on air. I missed you too, Joyce. Believe me. Absolutely informative topic. I think youth should listen to these topics. Always looking forward to the show. Thank you so much. Now we're going to be talking about it. We will get back to that, Mervyn Kirsten. We will definitely, as you can see, we are talking about different topics, but we're going to take some music, and then when we come back, we're going to say our bye-byes on the other side. This one here is from Leo.
The most awaited India Shopping Festival, Namaste India Easter Shopping Festival, takes place from the 1st to the 17th of March at Greville Racecourse infield area. Full new setup, park your car and walk straight into the expo, 17 days only, entry fee 10 rands, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily. Latest Indian products with loads of variety, you've asked for it and we have it. Astrology by Nikhil Gulati, Henna by Satya, refreshing restaurants. Be there at Namaste India Greville Racecourse infield, 1st to the 17th of March, 2024. Park and walk straight inside the expo.
Comes from Leo Anirudh Ravichandra, that one. It is now 15 minutes to the hour. Welcome back to the Youth Unplugged show with your Vati Revdi Pillai. Going to be keeping you company for the next few minutes until we actually start fading my voice off Southside FM's airwaves and give way to Tashriya and Alvin Tagat for the Triple T show, that is the Telugu Top 20. I need to know why Mahesh Babu songs are not on. We got to be talking to them in a bit. Now, Mervyn Kirsten, as you can see, one woman show here, running it. But thank you so much and I've got a child that I'm now going to look after and teach. Be a little bit patient with me, Mervyn. Because he says he wants to go and ask another station because he asked a question before. No problem. So he says he wants to know what's the name of the film and who sings the song. This is actually one of my favorite movies. I got an opportunity to open it. And it's actually Jodha Akbar. Jodha Akbar stars Aishwarya Rai and Hrithik Roshan. The Manamohana song is absolutely awesome. That one I can tell you, I don't know if I have it here to actually play it, but Mana Mohana is absolutely awesome. I really enjoyed that song. But the one he's actually showing to me now is Mugavari. That one there is Murumadi. Murumadi is the name of the song, Mervin, that you are looking up and asking for. So I'm hoping that was helpful to you. And if I had to go in more detail, and I'm trying to get more information from you, Srinivas, lyrics by Namuthukumar, and the song is Murumadi. The composer is our one and only, obviously, A.R. Rahman. He did an absolutely awesome job. My favorite is definitely the Krishna song from there that Aishwarya Rai sings. So the story is actually Aishwarya Rai, who's a princess of the Hindu clan, marrying Hrithik Roshan, who's from the Muslim clan, and how both of them start to understand each other. And so she said wherever she goes, she must bring her Khana with her. So that is why she takes Krishna with her, and she prays in his Muslim kingdom. So...
Is that the same movie with what's that song? Kanna Nitungada? No.
No,
that's Baahubali, yeah. My bad. But this movie sounds familiar because it seems
an old movie.
Yeah, it sounds so familiar though. I feel like maybe I've watched it a long time ago.
It's Jodha Akbar.
Yeah,
and it's purely about Hrithik Roshan and Aishwarya Rai.
Okay.
And you get the songs in all languages.
I actually
enjoyed every single one of them. But the one I think he sent me is Murumadi, A.R. Rahman. And Srinivas's beautiful, melodious voice playing there. Joyce says, please play Sid, my favorite. You know I'm going to be saying bye now. And I say bye. I say bye with Sid Sriram. You know that Kanjapuva Kanale, that won't change. But it is that time of the day. Thank you so much, Mako, for keeping me company for the past 3 hours. Absolutely enjoyed it. Happy to be back. Happy to, you know, be back on air. Thank you for all the messages on Facebook. So thank you for those support that I got there. I see a lot of people have been messaging on Facebook for all those messages that came through for Kavesan. Kavi, really appreciate the support that you give to the child. Remember, if you'd like to have a youngster on the show as my youth of the week, all you have to do is WhatsApp me on my youth WhatsApp number. That is a youth unplugged WhatsApp number. That is 067-601-7485. That is 067-601-7485. And we can make a plan and get them on air. We will definitely text you that information, Mervin. Appreciate it. And appreciate it to every single one of you. I'm going to give way now for Tashia and Alvin Tagat. And I must say, Dreshlin, thank you so much. I think you're doing a fine job. We're going to get you there.
Thank you.
You know what? We're just back, and I was hoping, and I can hear in your voice, you spent good time with the past 3 weeks. We just need to now fine tune you, and we'll get you there. And next week, we are going to definitely do.
With all that has been talking about, with the, what was it? The real. What was our new segment? The real. Anyway, with all those topics that have been happening,
right?
Let's get real. I was going to say Real Drive. I don't know why I was going to think Real Drive with Colin. Colin was just coming in my head. No. I'm just saying. No offense, Colin, if you're listening. But with all that talk about being real, be the difference you want to see in the world. And remember, it starts with you. Make the difference. And with that, that's me, Dreshlin Govender, signing out on Southside FM 107.2.
Thank you so much. And Joyce, thank you so much. She says, yes, I met him at the temple. Thank you so much, Joyce. Thank you to everybody that has been sending through. Sorry about the break in transmission. Hopefully that gets sorted out or is sorted out already. But until next week, this is your Bharti Revati Pillai signing off. Stay safe and stay blessed. And remember, no means no.
Vanakkam. I'm singer K.S. Chitra, and you are listening to Revati Pillai on Southside FM. Stay blessed.
The youth of SA is indeed the future of this country. It is an absolute privilege for me to host a show to tackle the current challenges and opportunities that affect them. As a youngster, there are many decisions that pave the way for the future. This show is aimed at supporting the youth and encouraging them to make that decision. You can join me, Revati Pillai, every Saturday between 9 to 12 as I bring four topics of interest. Remember, this is a show for the youth, by the youth.
Hi, this is Sid Sriram, and you are listening to Revati Pillai on Youth Unplugged. Are you tired of engine oils that don't deliver?
KZN Oils is proud to introduce Delo Gold 15W40 to our Chris Harney Road location. Come in today and experience the power of premium engine protection.